Hello and welcome to this lecture on the lattice Boltzmann method. So in the previous lecture, I spoke about some introductory concepts of the multiple relaxation time model or the generalized lattice Boltzmann method. So today I'll talk about the generalized two-dimensional LB. So as an example on how the MRT formulation works and what goes behind the calculation process. So in this generalized method, what we'll see is we'll be constructing of space based upon the velocity moments of f alpha. So we'll have 9 independent moments that I'll discuss. So I'm talking on 2D, so it basically means D2Q9, which means we'll have 9 moments. Now, this moment representation, you know, the reason it is very attractive is because it provides a convenient and effective means by which to incorporate physics into LBE. And more importantly, in the context of kinetic theory, these physical processes such as viscous transport, these can be easily approximated by the coupling or interaction among different modes. So as I said, we'll have 9 moments, and 9 each of them will correspond to a mode, and these modes are going to be directly related to these moments. So we'll talk about these modes very shortly. So because there is a coupling between these modes in themselves with the physical processes, so the physical parameters or with the relaxation parameters or the moments are going to be directly related to the viscous transport coefficients. So we'll see that the modes are actually in some form functions of these viscous transport properties, and each of these modes will be controlled independently. So they will actually have their own equation when we'll have to solve those equations to be able to determine the evolution of a fluid in space and time. So as I said, we'll have moments of f alpha and the 9 modes. So as I said, so we'll have, I can write this down here, that we have moments of the distribution function, the velocity distribution function, which would lead to 9 modes, and their discrete velocity set, if I may say so. So the velocity set will actually correspond to the following modes. So let me write this down again in the same notation that I was using earlier. So we'll have a density mode, then we'll have an energy mode, we'll also have a mode corresponding to, which I'm representing as alpha, to be the energy square. Then we'll have the x component mode, so x momentum mode I should say. We'll have an x component of energy flux, then we'll have the y component of momentum, so y momentum mode, then finally we'll have the y component of energy flux. And subsequently we'll have 2 modes corresponding to the, one would be corresponding to diagonal component of the stress tensor, so I have said this as pxx, and then we'll also have an off diagonal component of the stress tensor. So these 9 will actually give us a velocity set in the moment space. So we could represent the moments as a vector as well. So for instance, I could write the vector of all moments as rho e epsilon jx, sorry, that would be qx jy q sub y pxx pxy transpose. So this will be a vector representation of the moments. So the reason I'm writing it like this is that there would, as I'll show you, there will exist a transformation matrix which I'm going to represent by M. This will be a transformation matrix in the generalized LBE which will be used to transform moments which are, let's say, this parameter rho here to the velocity space distribution function. So the transformation that I'm talking about would be that this rho could be written as some m times f, or f could be written as m inverse rho, and this m is actually what is the main, you know, factor that will allow us to control these, the physics with many more parameters in this problem. Now m has a very specific nature, so it can be written in the form of rho elements, and the way it can be written is that we can have the, if I write it down, let's say if I want to mention this, so rho, the rho elements, again if you look back, the first rho will correspond to the first rho will correspond to density, second is to energy, and then energy square, and so on and so forth. So I could say that rho of alpha, where alpha is the column vector or the column number, would be e alpha naught, or e alpha raised to 0, which is 1. So we'll see that the first rho of m will actually be 1, which corresponds to the rho mode, or rather the density mode. The second rho, which corresponds to the energy mode, will be minus 4 e alpha naught plus 3 e alpha x square plus e alpha y square. The energy square mode contribution in the M matrix will be something like 4 e alpha naught minus 21 by 2 e alpha x square plus e alpha y square plus 9 by 2 e alpha x square plus e alpha y square square. The momentum jx will be just e alpha x, and I should say alpha. Similarly, qx alpha would be minus 5 e alpha naught plus 3 e alpha x square e alpha y square times e alpha x, and jy alpha would just be e alpha y, qy alpha would be minus 5 e alpha naught plus 3 e alpha x square plus e alpha y square e alpha y. Then we'll have qy, which is done, sorry, we'll have px x, which is the normal stress, to be e alpha x square minus e alpha y square, and we'll have p x y to be e alpha x e alpha y. So we'll now have these 9 rows in our M matrix. Now if I use a D2Q9 lattice, which is what we would be employing for this discussion, and let me put those directions here. So I'll be using 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So this is the D2Q9 lattice, where we are actually using that E0, you know, when alpha is 0, that basically becomes the rest particle. And then as alpha goes from 1, 2, 3, 4, and so forth, you get these individual directions. So for these components, if you start calculating each of these values, so as alpha goes from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 till 8, if you calculate, you can get that the M vector or the M matrix will actually be a square matrix of this type. So this is actually a 9x9 matrix. And now you can actually verify that these are the values that you will get. For instance, if I look at the first contribution, this is, which is 1. So the first row is actually all is composed of all 1s. So that is taken care of. The second row, for instance, if I look at E alpha naught, so this will be minus 4. And as you go along from one direction to another, so let's say alpha is 0, so this will be 0. And so the only thing you'll see is minus 4, which you get here. But as you go along, let's say when I say alpha is 1, so in that case, we'll have, this will be still minus 4, but then you'll have 3, alpha, E alpha x will be 1, E alpha y would be 0. So you'll get 3 into 1 square minus 4, which will make it minus 1. And so you'll have minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1 here. And then you'll get 2, 2, 2 because you'll have E alpha x square plus E alpha y square will be 2 in each of those directions. So this becomes 6, 6 minus 4 is 2. So you get these 2s here and then you can actually calculate the rest of them. Now, rather than spending time on, you know, now calculating this, and just I just wanted to put it down here to show you that this is how the matrix M is obtained. I wanted to talk more about how these rows are arranged. So these rows are arranged in the following order. And the order goes like this. Rows 1 to 3 are composed of scalars, or these are also 0th order tensors. So these are 0th, 2nd and 4th order moments of F alpha. Remember, what I'm saying is the density, for example, the first row corresponds to 0th moment of F. Then we had energy, which is the 2nd order moment of F. And then we have energy square, which becomes the 4th order moment of F or F alpha. The second, you know, second set of rows, which are rows 4 to 7, these are vectors, or which we call as first order tensors. So we have Jx and Jy, which are first order moments of F alpha. And then we have Qx and Qy, which are third order moments of F alpha. So that makes it 4. And then finally, the last bit, which is rows 8 and 9. These are actually components of the stress tensor. Okay, so these are actually second order moments. So now, having described all the moments, the modes, now let's look at how do these moments, or rather these modes, actually evolve with time. That is the whole idea of doing this generalized representation. So what I'm going to talk about is the evolution equation for these non-conserved moments. So one assumption that I should mention here now is that we assume that these non-conserved moments relax linearly towards their equilibrium values. And these equilibrium values will actually be functions of the conserved quantities. So what I mean is, if I now look at the non-conserved moments, for instance, I can say E star, which is the new value of E, would be E minus S2 E minus E equilibrium. And this is actually very similar to the way we've been writing F star, which was F minus some parameter. In this case, our case, it was the distribution function, or rather the relaxation time, F minus F equilibrium. So this has an analogy with that earlier representation. So now we write this for all the non-conserved moments. Similarly, epsilon star is epsilon minus S3. Let's say epsilon minus epsilon equilibrium. Then we can say Qx star would be Qx minus, this would be S5, Qx minus Qx equilibrium. We will have Qy star to be Qy minus S7, Qy minus Qy equilibrium, and then we'll have Pxx star to be Pxx minus S8, Pxx minus Pxx equilibrium, and finally Pxy star to be Pxy minus S9, Pxy minus Pxy equilibrium. Now let's talk about the equilibrium values of these non-conserved moments. So in the MRT method, as I said, the equilibrium values are chosen, or the equilibrium values are functions of the conserved quantities. The conserved quantities in our case are the density and the two momentum components. So the equilibrium values are chosen as functions of these variables, but they are chosen in such a way that symmetry has to be ensured. So the equilibrium values of these non-conserved moments can be chosen in any form as long as symmetry is ensured, which would mean that if I transform the axis, I should still get the same values of these equilibrium or these non-equilibrium moments, because the frame of reference should not be deciding on how the problem, you know, or the physical properties in a system. So for instance, let me take an example. Let me look at E equilibrium, which is the equilibrium value of the energy. So I could write this as 1 by EE, which is to normalize it. Then we say alpha 2 rho into the rho value plus gamma 2. I can write this as jx square plus jy of jy square. Close it here. Now what I've done here is, we have taken the row vectors and the row columns, I mean for M, and we're going to normalize them. So these are specific values to be able to normalize this entire function. And alpha 2 and gamma 2 are actually our arbitrary constants. Now the way this is commonly written is, if you now look at, for example, let me show you what EE is, just to clarify. For example, if we look at the M matrix, E corresponds to the, it is actually the second moment. So we need to basically multiply each element of this row with itself. So it would be minus 4 into minus 4, plus minus 1 into minus 1, plus minus 1 into minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, and so on and so forth. And then we add them up. That is what EE would mean. So this will be minus 4 square plus, we'll have minus 1 square, but that would come out like 4 times, plus 2 square, and that would also come out 4 times. So this will be 16 plus 4 plus, this will be again 4 into 4, 16. So this will be 36. And if you look at row, this will be 1 into, so this is 1 into 1 plus 1 into 1. So this would be 1 into 9. So we'll have 9. So for instance, so I can say that row by EE will actually be 1 by 4. So I can now write that E equilibrium would be 1 by 4 alpha 2 into rho, because it's a function of the conserved quantities, plus the next term will actually, which you can work out, is going to be 1 by 6 gamma 2 jx square plus jy square. And as I said, these parameters can be chosen as per the choice. So this actually will come out to be minus 2 rho, or this is how it's prescribed to be, that this is written as minus 2 rho plus 3 jx square plus jy square. Similarly, epsilon equilibrium is taken as rho minus 3 jx square plus jy square. Qx equilibrium is just taken as minus jx, and similarly Qy equilibrium is taken as minus jy, and Pxx equilibrium is taken as 1 by 3 jx square minus jy square. Pxy equilibrium is just 1 by 3 jx jy. So these properties, as I said, are computed now. These equilibrium functions are computed based on the conserved quantities that are known at any given time. So this function, this whole idea that I've written here, is actually giving us the post-collision values of these moments. Now the generalized LBE works pretty much the same way as I said in terms of the overall LBE. So the post-collision distributions, or these post-collision moments, if I write in terms of, let's say, M tilde, this is supposed to be M times F tilde, where F tilde I can now write are post-collision distributions. Okay, so I can now compute the post-collision distribution functions as M inverse into M tilde. Or I could actually say this is, going to the notation that I was using, I could maybe say this is rho tilde. I should not have used M, but anyway. But I can say it's that rho of all those components of the moment space. Now, so either we can do this, or in practice the more convenient way of doing this collision equation is that we can calculate the post collision distribution function in the velocity space as in the following way. We can write F tilde is F minus M inverse into S into moment space minus moment equilibrium function, where this function M is basically the same transformation matrix, and M inverse can also be computed. Incidentally, M doesn't change over the course of the simulation, so you just have to do this calculation once at the beginning of the of the initialization part. But this S is actually a diagonal matrix which has the following values. So it has the first element is 0, S2, S3, 0, S5, S6 is 0, S7, S8, S9, and these actually are from the previous lecture where I was talking about eigenvalues. Okay, that the S, the collision, the function or the matrix S is what is composed of these inverse of in some way these eigenvalues, and so they are inverse of that, those eigenvalues are actually related to the relaxation time, and in the BJK operator all these functions or these S are actually taken to be equal as 1 by tau. So these parameters which I'm defining as S2, S3, S5, S7, S8, S9, these can be chosen quite flexibly. So there is a lot of room in terms of choosing these values, but the only thing in principle these should be more than one. They should be greater than one. And the other thing is this variable S8 and S9, because they're correlated to the stress tensor, these should actually be equal to 1 by tau for us to recover the kinetic or the kinematic diffusivity, which is tau minus half into 1 by 3, which happens to be in the generalized or in the LBGK model. So this is one requirement. Now, as I said, so it has maximum number of parameters which can be adjusted. So these parameters can now be adjusted to be able to achieve a stable dynamics of our simulation. So what I'll do is I will actually show you a sample in one of my forthcoming videos on how the MRT method can be used to solve a sample problem in Lattice-Boltzmann method. Now, the other thing that I also should mention is that the next step in this process is that once you have these post-collision distributions, which are these F values, the process goes very similar to what we've been doing so far. So once you have the post-collision distributions, we stream these distributions to the neighboring nodes. So streaming goes as it is, but that goes in the velocity space. So you stream and then you apply boundary conditions. At the end of applying boundary conditions, we get the final distributions, the F values. At that point, again, we recover the moments based on the transformation matrix M. So at the end of the transformation or at the end of the streaming and bounce back process, we again recover the moments and then you move ahead in time. So then you go to the next time step where again the moments are used to perform collision. So we calculate again based on the newest value of moments. We calculate these, equilibrium functions, do a collision in moment space, or even in, depends on if you use this equation in its entirety, if you jump the step and you just use this equation, you can actually just use the available values of moments and calculate the distribution function, and then the process goes on. So that is the general idea or the general principle behind MRT, and I will show you that through a code in one of the, as I said, in one of the forthcoming videos. So thank you for listening, and see you next time.